Hi, this is Prios. In this video, I'm gonna show you an interesting PLO hand that happened between Jan-Peter Jachtmann and Darwin in the King's Casino. This time, I will also play the original commentary. Please tell me if you like this format more with or without the original commentary.
Watching. Hope you're enjoying. Oh, it's got up to 240 there. Anybody wants to talk about anything? I did the commentary last weekend in the PLO and the No Limit, and the Super High Roller was fun to do. Hoping to see some big pots in this tonight. Kaiser wants to play two hands.
Everyone is folding to Jachtmann, who is on the button. He is making an extremely loose open raise. Darwin goes ahead and 3-bets him. This definitely makes sense given how loose Jachtmann is playing. I think the hand should have ended preflop now. Because after getting re-raised, I don't like my hand anymore and throw it away. Actually, I would have folded already the first time around and wouldn't have tried to steal the blind with trash like this. But I don't think Jachtmann can make this lay down. I think he will continue to play. Let's see what he decides.
I think it's scheduled to go for 4 hours. So this is my last day in King's Rosvodov. I've had a great week and I'm going to be home for 3 days, then I'm off to Barcelona. Top two for Jachtmann. Nut flush draw for Darwin.
This looks like fireworks. Both people make top two. Although Jachtmann hits the board hard, he still is way, way behind against Darwin's monster. He is holding top two, plus a flush draw and overcards as well that can improve his hand.
And top two. this is a hand he should be betting with. Jachtmann may call, may even take a little stab at it with top two. Probably doesn't want to see a heart on the turn, so he'll probably just call. No, reaching to raise. If he does, I'd expect Darwin to re-raise. This is a perfect opportunity for Darwin.
Actually, I have to correct myself. He just has one overcard, but still enough to have Jachtmann in bad shape. Jachtmann elects to raise a flop. I think he should have just called. Raising is bad because of several reasons. With a raise, Jachtmann is isolating himself against the range that is having him crushed. By raising, he's driving out all bluffs. People who 3-bet preflop love to represent aces, for example, but if you raise them, they will not continue to bluff. Calling is definitely the way to go, trying to hit a safe turn. I'm not sure if Darwin should call or re-raise now. There are arguments for both. With his hand, you basically can't go wrong unless you somehow fold your hand.
Top two nut flush draw. Doesn't get much better than that. I think Jachtmann's made a mistake there. He's definitely raising, by the way. % raising.
Darwin decides to make the more aggressive move, 3-betting the flop. Now it's back on Jachtmann. This is a really tough spot. This is another reason why I hate his re-raise. Well, to be correct, the raise. The hand plays out much more smooth if he's just calling the flop. After raising the flop, we might be committed if Darwin is making this play with some draws as well. It's definitely a close spot. Another reason why I hate raising the flop. I want to raise a range that is a clear fold after getting 3-bet or an easy all-in. I don't like hands that are in between. This is a concept of polarization. If I would have raised the flop, I probably still fold after getting 3-bet. But I would hate life having to fold my hand after putting in that much money. I also would hit myself for making such a stupid play. Let's see what Yachtman will do. I expect him to go into the tank and after a long while make some sort of decision. This is also a big leak of him. He's not thinking ahead, or at least not thinking ahead enough. If you make a raise in a spot like this, you should already know what to do. I mean, there shouldn't be something unexpected that you have to go into the tank for several minutes. This is one main skill that a good poker player has to have. You have to think through the hand in your head already and know what to do, if he's just calling, if he's raising, what is happening on several turn cards, yada yada yada. And I saw Yachtman really often in the past not knowing what to do if something unexpected happens. So he definitely should work on this part of his game.
Well, he's representing a set of aces here, or the hand he's got, which is top two nut flush draw, or two pair with a rat. Got in a bit of trouble anyway. If he had flatted and a club came, then they would have got it all in. Or a four. Playing last night in a cash game, and Yachtman should know Davin is not one to get his chips in light. He led out, he's been raised, and he's re-raised. He is literally turning his cards face up and telling you, I have you crushed. Now, we can see he's got the same hand, but he's got the best draw. Stick 20,000 in for a possible split. No.
He finally made one good decision in the hand. So far, I hated almost every decision he made. I think he shouldn't have tried to steal the blinds in the first place. After he was getting 3-bet preflop, he should have folded his hand. After and on the flop, he should have just called and not raised. But in the end, he actually, at one point, after playing like a fool all the time, he made one correct decision in the hand. This is the end of the analysis. I hope you enjoyed it. If that's the case, please like and subscribe. Feel free to check out my other videos as well. Thanks for watching. Good luck at the tables. Bye bye.